macOS Ventura 13.0.1 may cause, with some unsupported Macs, a kind of screen flickering while you're trying to log in. So you cannot enter your password anymore and you cannot access your Mac anymore. So first of all, thank you for all the comments below my videos, especially about Ventura and the last update, because with all that feedback, I now can spread this news to the whole community. Some unsupported Macs, and especially it's the iMac 2013 and 2015 and the MacBook Pro 2016, may experience an error when updating to Ventura 13.0.1. That error is that the screen starts to flicker when you're trying to log in, and it seems like it's switching back and forth from light to dark mode, and you cannot even enter your password, and therefore you cannot access your Mac anymore. I'd like to give you a hint to our sponsor, that is Clean My Mac X from MacPaw. If you're using your old Mac hardware for quite a long time, you've done some projects or installed and uninstalled many apps, that might build up some leftovers and slow your macOS down. And especially if you are planning on upgrading, it's very advisable that you use Clean My Mac X before you do that, to just get rid of all the junk and to get your macOS as clean as possible to avoid any problems with updating. And especially with Black Friday coming up, there are a lot of good deals, and check out the link in the video description. I have a lot of reports of all other kind of Macs, and I just checked my list here. The MacBook Pro 2012, 13, 14, and 15. The MacBook Air 2013, I tested that myself. The Mac Mini 2012 and 2014, that's my device here behind me. And the iMac 2012, and some other reports from the iMac 2013 and 15, they all say the update went smooth and there was nothing to report. So we will have to dig deeper into that, and therefore I need your help. Please give me feedback, and give me feedback from all other devices as well, so I can just get all into that and we can maybe pinpoint down what is the problem, which models are affected, and I can relay that to the OpenCore and legacy patcher developers, so maybe they can have a look into that as well. Some other question that always comes up, and I'd like to answer that right here for everyone: does the legacy patcher save the settings? When I just change some settings, I apply it, I install it, and I reboot, and then I open the legacy patcher again, it's all back to normal. And that is correct. Both is correct. The OpenCore legacy patcher, when you change the setting, then you click on build and install OpenCore and you install it to a EFI partition, that setting is written on the EFI partition, and when you reboot now, OpenCore loads these settings. If you open the legacy patcher again, it always gets to the defaults for your Mac model. And one other question that comes here and there: I updated to Ventura or Monterey, but it's kind of slow, or I don't like it. I want to go back to an older macOS like Big Sur or Catalina. Can I downgrade my macOS? Unfortunately, you cannot. If you have updated your macOS, and that's the same with the iPhone or iPad, if you updated your iOS or iPadOS, you cannot go back. The only way for a Mac to go to an older macOS is that you wipe your hard disk completely and you reinstall that older macOS from scratch. It's tricky if you have a Time Machine backup from a newer macOS to get this backup, the data from this backup, back on your old macOS. So if you want to do that and you have very sensitive data or important data on your Mac, I recommend you either have a second hard drive if you can switch it, and swap another hard drive, install the old macOS, and then copy your data manually, because the Time Machine is not intended to get a backup of a newer macOS into your older macOS, because the older macOS Time Machine software cannot always handle the newer Time Machine backup. That feature doesn't work when you have to install the graphic drivers with the post-installed root patch. Why? Because the devs just took the graphic drivers from macOS Monterey and implemented them back into Ventura, but the drivers are not ready for that feature yet. I don't know if they are working on that feature with high priority. I think their first focus is on giving the Mac Pro 6.1 and 5.1 the opportunity to install Ventura. As I said, please give me the comments in the video below if your Mac handled the update well, if there are any problems. If you haven't yet, I would recommend you subscribe to the channel and click the bell for a notification so you don't miss any more news. And I try to keep you updated as soon as I hear something from the community, out of the forums, or from your feedback, obviously. And thank you very much for watching. See you soon. Bye bye.